For anyone acquainted with the fact that the Earth is getting warmer, it should come as no surprise that 2023 was the hottest year on record. However, climate change is not a linear process. The extent of the warming in 2023 is quite shocking, even to climate science experts. This is no slowly creeping phenomenon. The heat and ensuing disaster is accelerating. Since June, almost every single day of 2023 blew away all previous daily heat records. The average temperature for 2023 was 1.48 degrees Celsius above pre-civilization levels, while the 2020 average was only 0.8 degrees above that. 2024 is shaping up to be even hotter, blowing past the 1.5 degree point, which the 2015 Paris Climate Accords promised to prevent. A recent report by the internationally renowned charity Oxfam has again exposed the murderous role of the capitalist class in the climate crisis. To address this crime against humanity, the only solution is to overthrow capitalist rule through a socialist revolution. Oxfam's report reveals, since the 1990s, the super-rich 1% burned through twice as much of the carbon budget as the poorest half of humanity combined. Part of these emissions come from their extravagant personal consumption, such as private jets and yachts, but even more from investment in polluting industries. The report correctly puts the blame where it belongs, saying, "The super-rich are burning our world." The international bourgeoisie and their mouthpieces try to portray the increasingly destructive climate disasters either as natural or simply human. But in 2019, this 1% accounted for the same amount of emissions as the bottom 66%, some 5 billion working people. Oxfam concludes that emissions are enough to cause 1.3 million deaths due to heat, and this is for a single year. In fact, the international bourgeoisie is investing twice as much in fossil fuels as what the International Energy Agency sees as the maximum in order to avert a climate catastrophe. Unbothered by the blood dripping from every capitalist pore, US oil and gas production is set to break records in 2023. However, we should not just regard the capitalists as irresponsible individuals. This is the ruling class, which dominates the world economy, politics, and culture. The Carbon Majors report shows that 100 big companies are responsible for over 70% of global emissions. Furthermore, the reign of the profit incentive under capitalism leads to active sabotages of the transition toward clean energy. The Financial Times reports, around $8 billion worth of Chinese solar panels are currently sitting in European warehouses, which is enough to power all the homes in London and Paris combined for a year. But it's more lucrative for the companies to stock them for future sales rather than use this technology for the benefit of humanity. So much for capitalist innovation. These are glaring examples of the total irrationality of capitalism today, which threatens the very future of humanity. But what is to be done? Oxfam proposes that our capitalist government should tax the rich and use the money for social and ecological reforms. Although they admit governments are often too reluctant to intervene because they are blinded by neoliberal thinking or controlled by powerful elites. But these same governments are not so reluctant when it comes to increasing military spending or bailing out big banks. The more serious bourgeois realize that a total environmental collapse would be detrimental to their own interests. But the logic of capitalism, confined by the narrow limits of private property in the nation-state, dooms any substantial action from them. International conferences like the recent COP28 have no intention nor power to resolve the crisis. This recent conference was presided by the CEO of the United Arab Emirates State Oil Company, and attended by thousands of fossil fuel lobbyists. It is criminally naive to believe that the capitalist world leaders can negotiate and cooperate in good faith. In fact, data has proven that countries and companies consistently fail to report accurate emissions per the Paris Climate Agreement obligations. As communists, we do not put any trust in the capitalist state, which is an organ of class rule. Seeing the US political establishment back Israel's genocidal war on Gaza, while over two-thirds of Americans are in favor of stopping the massacre, should expose the sham of bourgeois democracy. We also have no illusions that the climate crisis can be resolved within the confines of capitalism, which is the system of those responsible for this crisis. Let's be clear, militant working class movements might force the capitalists to make some concessions, and communists are absolutely in favor of fighting for these reforms. However, changes within the system do not address the fundamental problem. The culprits are left with their economic and political might intact, and their bloody business still provides enough profit incentive. Further, the workers and oppressed can't remain mobilized forever. Unless they are capped with a victorious revolution, mass movements inevitably ebb. It is then that the emboldened ruling class takes back any gains won through the struggle, as we saw in the case of Roe v. Wade. Fortunately, there is a way out. The socialist revolution. The working class today produces immense wealth, more than enough to reverse the climate breakdown and drastically improve the living standard for the majority. We have also seen that we have the technology to start this process. All that is needed is for the revolutionary workers and youth to take the economy into our own hands and run it democratically in a socialist society prioritizing human needs instead of profit making. Again, we have the power to do so. In fact, not a wheel turns and not a light bulb shines without the permission of the working class. To fight for the end of the capitalist climate disaster, fight for the communist future of humanity.